tonight for the most of you has been asking about something that we need in Baker. With me this evening, I have Mr. Jaziri Bazell. Nice to meet you.
All right. Greetings, sir.
All right. And Mr. Bazell is the CEO of Mind Corporation, and he's also with Grow Baton Rouge. And I met this young man a couple of days ago. I actually met him a couple of weeks ago when we were doing our gardening. All of you know that Councilwoman and the President of the Council, Glenda Bryant, has this beautification goal that she has, and we're doing a lot of gardening here. We're growing gardens all over the city gardens, and he was out here helping, and he's been a great help for us in our plans and our goals. So if you can, Ms. Bazell, tell us a little bit about what you guys do when it comes to community gardens and projects across the city, and what you guys can do to help Baker.
All right. So overall, the CEO Mind Foundation is unity, community, family, equipped on providing tangible skills, tangible outcomes, workforce development, entrepreneurship, but education, equipping the communities, right?
Right.
So one of our biggest pushes or initiatives is Grow Baton Rouge. Grow Baton Rouge is centered around food insecurity, food deserts, teaching people agribusiness, agriculture, everything from in schools. We have indoor grow labs where you don't need any windows. We have greenhouses. We restructured some greenhouses in Baton Rouge, and we have many community gardens. By the end of this year, our goal is to put 30 community gardens like the ones we help Baker with.
Right.
But we want to teach the community how to grow, because going back to health and wellness is extremely important for us to be able to eat well, and more so than anything, people need access. There's a lot of people out here that don't have access to food because they don't have transportation. So many issues go into it. We want to show the people that they can be a part of solving this, right?
That's right.
One of the other biggest things that we launched at the beginning of June was the farmers markets, the Grow Baton Rouge
Farmers Markets. Right, talk a little bit about that.
So the farmers markets are in the community for the people, and it's a combination of farmers and makers markets. So it's not only fresh food and fresh produce, but you're able to come out, vendors, small businesses, get your products, get your wares, eat some food, listen to some music, kind of hang out with the community, but also get their fresh food and their fresh produce. A lot of produce is grown directly from people of the community, from our community gardens, but we also bring in local farmers, various things of that nature. And by this time next year, I would say we're going for 98% of all produce to come from there.
Right.
Some of the fruit is hard to get local in certain parts of the year, because you know, it's cycle. The cycle is the season.
Right.
But overall, the goal is to provide the access to the community. We're talking to young people, the people that live in the community. We're talking to seniors. Across the board, we want to work with everybody to expand this so that you're eating right, you're eating good.
Right. So nutritional, and so you have the nutritional goals that goes on with them. Do you guys do any type of classes of anything to give people that information?
So it's a few things with that, right? So for the community gardens in specific, whenever we do a community garden, we do outreach to the community. Come get involved with that whole process. Learn how to grow. And based on who's out there, you'll be educated on various aspects of that. The farmers markets in particular, we do food demos, we do health education while we're there, so you can actually leave with some recipes. And if it's something you've never cooked before, patty pan squash perhaps, right? You've never seen it, you never cooked with it.
Right.
We're going to demonstrate how to cook that, what to eat with. You know,
okay.
So it's awesome in a way that you get to get the produce that you're used to. You can introduce some other things. This past weekend we had purple bell peppers.
Right.
Most people had never seen purple bell peppers before. And it's one of those things to where we're going to have some unique things that you can't find in the grocery store.
So we are going to do one in Baker.
It's coming.
So tell me a little bit about that and the date and time and what we're going to do.
So we're looking Baker last weekend, last Saturday of the month.
So okay.
Y'all ready for that. Baker, y'all better be ready for
right.
Last Saturday of the month, we're going 10 a.m. We're going to roll through 1 p.m. Come out with your family. We're going to do it in the park, right?
Right.
So you're going to get to hang out with some people. Come meet the mayor. Come meet everybody.
Right.
We're going to connect. You're going to get some food. You're going to get some produce. It's going to be awesome. And you can learn how to grow food at home, too, because we're going to give away some soil and some seed.
Right.
Right? So that's what we're going to do. The 28th of July.
Right.
So tell everybody. Everybody needs to know about this. So,
okay.
And, of course, looking forward to a great partnership with the city on these programs and various other programs to get people involved to heal and help the city of Baker.
Okay, so look, let's get it out here, Baker. We know how to get it out here. Get it out here on Facebook, okay? 28 July, 3 days after my birthday, okay? Come on out to the farmers market. We've been talking about it. We've been wanting it. We've been talking about it for years and years and years. Now we have it. God has blessed us with it. And this young man and his organization are going to come out, and we're going to put on a great show for you. Make sure that you bring the family. It's going to start at 10 o'clock in the morning. We're going to go to 1 o'clock. We're going to have all kind of things out there for you. So if you want to be involved, if you want to get involved with this, make sure you call City Hall, 778 0300 if you want to be a volunteer. So we got it. Put it out on Facebook for me. Make sure you let the seniors know. Just let everybody know what's going on that day. And that's going to be at the park next to the municipal building right there. It's going to be a great, great day. Now, before we get out of here, just tell us a little bit about some goals that you guys have in the future.
So overall, the future, we run what we call the Youth Empowerment Zone. Right. It's one of the most innovative STEAM, and we say STEAM because it's science, technology, engineering, agriculture, arts, math, and media programs in Baton Rouge. We want to bring that to Baker as well. And that has a huge amount of educational, workforce development, entrepreneurship, stuff like that. We want to combine that. That goes in also with Grow Baton Rouge. But just infrastructure, we want to be a partner for Baker and building people, building community, and just the goals overall of the people and the vision that you have for the city.
That's it. How long have you been doing this?
Business-wise, I've been... The business portion of it since I was 17, which I want...
It's been a long time.
That's right.
Community-related, globally, I've been doing a lot of community stuff for the past 12 years or so.
Right.
And only community stuff for the past 6 years.
Right.
So... been building across the planet. Literally, we have things in Nairobi, in Kenya, so across the United States, but came home to Baton Rouge, Louisiana, to help the communities here and help Bill take the knowledge and the wealth of experience that I had to help build communities here.
Well, I really appreciate you coming to Baker, and I appreciate everything you're going to do. Okay, Baker, let's show them some love here on July 28th, and let's bring a whole lot of people out to the farmers market, and we'll be right back. Let us go and pay some bills. Come back.